could buy my way to heaven. When I awoke, I smit that on a necklace. I told God I'd be back in a second. Man, it's so hard not to act reckless. To whom much is given, much is tested. Get arrested, guess until he get the message. I feel the pressure under more.
Talking to the future with Jovante Gray. Today I'm interviewing a young Detroit actor named Jovante Thompson. He's from Detroit School of Art, and he is a very amazing actor. How are you today, Jovante?
How you doing, man?
Good. So, getting into it, what made you want to become an actor?
I mean, when I was little, I used to do nothing but just watch TV and, like, movies and over again. Like, I was really overstimulated with it. Like my whole day would just be watch this movie, watch that movie. And, like, it just amazed me that this was possible. Like, I don't know. You know how little kids think when they see movies and stuff like that, they think magic and all that. And, by the time I was like 3, I was in like my first like church play. Now, a church play is normally, you know, just a play to some people, but for me, it was a lot of fun. Like, I enjoyed it. I always got a lot of attention, and I enjoyed a lot of attention. And people would always come to me and say, you did real good on this line right here, or your face was so serious and stuff like that. And as I grew up, they put me in just about every one. And by the time I turned 8, I took it like really serious, and I started looking up auditions and stuff like that. And eventually I got to the Detroit School of Arts. Eventually I found my theater group, and I've just been acting ever since.
So you said theater groups. What theater groups or performance groups are you a part of?
I'm with a less known theater group. Like, most people in Detroit know about, like, Mosaic and... Oh, you okay, man? Okay. all right. Most people know about, like, Mosaic or Teen Hype. I'm with a smaller, less known group by the name of Castle. That's spelled C-A-S-O-E. Creative Art Spirit of Excellence. Now, like, we've been around for some time now, and there's a couple students at DSA who actually is with me in that group. We just finished doing this play called A Dream That Never Sleeps. It was an amazing play written by Miss Janet Smith, who's an amazing writer. And when you get, like, a smaller group like that, I feel like it's a lot more to live up to, like, because you're still trying to build up to that level of the Mosaics and even bigger stuff like that. Like, eventually we want to build our own castle in the city of Detroit, like, literally. And it's a lot of energy that you get from those, especially starting off small. So I enjoy it, and I plan to keep on doing it. And there's also this other group that I'm starting. It's a rumor now, but hopefully, if the guys that we're with get on board, it will be reality. It's called 313 Entertainment with 4 guys. Me, this guy right here, and Tim and Dwayne. You had them on here before.
Yeah, you had, okay.
They didn't mention it because, I don't know. But
How was being a Detroit citizen made you to the actor you are today?
You know, that's a funny question. I always like starting off small. I like the story behind it. Like, I never really had too many resources. Like, when I wanted to go to acting school and all that, my mom didn't really have the money, but she still, like, helped me get through it. Like, she had paid for it and all that, even though it was a complete struggle. And you don't have that many resources in Detroit for actors. Like, every once in a while, there may be a big film that comes through, and, like, a lot of actors from all over line up to get there, and it's a big chance. Like Star Wars. When Star Wars had came to, I believe, Southfield for auditions, and, like, the line was out the door. I couldn't even audition for it. They had gave me a paper and said send in a video audition. And with Detroit, you don't have too many movie production studios, you don't have too many TV production studios, like, unless it's like local television or something like that. You don't have that platform as a New York or Chicago or Los Angeles. You work with what you have, and basically it's not a lot. So it forces you to work harder. It forces you to have a better passion, which I believe develop anyone to do better at whatever they're doing. If you have a passion that's burning, and like, it's a big fire, like it's just always burning constantly, like, it will just drive you to do what you want to do.
So let's say you became a famous actor. What would you do to make it possible for other people other youth in Detroit to become actors?
I always thought to myself, if I became a famous actor, I would not stop there. I would always want to build, I always wanted to build a film production studio fairly close to Detroit. Like, I always wanted to make a big one, like, to give other actors like me a chance. Like, because coming from Detroit, most of the time, there's not too many people with a lot of money, you know, because you have, like, not too far away from here, you have, like, Arden Park in Boston where the mansions are. And, of course, housing in Detroit is a lot more expensive than the surrounding areas. So to be there, you have a lot of money. And when you go out of that area, you see some pretty big ghettos. And, you know, a lot of really devoted and wealthy people in today's, you know, media and industry and acting or whatever they're doing, they came from a small startup. They didn't have a lot. And if I could make it to be a big actor, I would just want to give back. I would want someone who don't have that much to start
off
with.
So speaking of giving back, what would you change about Detroit if you could change anything about Detroit to give something back?
I always think about that. I would give more outlets. There's a lot of talented people in Detroit, and they don't have much at all, like I was just saying. And if I could just give them something, like a little studio for the people who want to make music but can't afford it, a studio for the people who would like to possibly make like YouTube videos or something like that, that would be pretty good. And any other thing, the little recreation center for people who want to swim and want to study anything with a lot of books, like law books, because we know we have a lot of smart people in Detroit. They might want to be lawyers or something like that. So yeah.
So this is Talking to the Future with Jovante Gray. Remember, the future isn't always tomorrow, but today. And do me a favor, can you go beneath this video, like, subscribe, comment, share us. If you want to interview, hit up the Better Detroit Youth Movement email. It is in underneath this video. Have a nice day. Peace out, y'all.
Stuff.